Please welcome to the show, Te Kai Whakahaere o Ngai Tahu, Lisa Tumahai. Morena, Lisa.
Morena
whānau. Oh, it's been a few years since we've had a kōrero on the breakfast show, and a lot has happened, including you are now a tauā.
People who have known me know that I've been wanting to be a tauā for a long time. So we're so blessed to have two beautiful baby girls come along. And the twins are 10 months now, so time has gone past really quickly. But it's a whole new experience.
Do they keep you busy, Lisa? Do they keep you busy?
Oh, yeah, they do. They do, as I keep now driving backwards and forwards to Ōtautahi, to be able to visit them because they're just growing so fast.
Oh, that's so cute. Now, recently we learned Ngai Tahu have decided to exit its partnership with Te Pū Tahitanga o Te Waipounamu. That's after 8 years of working together. Can you tell us a bit more about this?
It's been a decision that we have put a great deal of careful thought into for some time now. This hasn't been a sudden decision. We believe that it's the right time for us to lead in this space. If we want to directly fulfil the goals and aspirations of our whānau, we're taking an iwi-led approach that gives true effect to tino rangatiratanga to achieve a better equitable well-being outcome for Ngai Tahu whānui. We're taking responsibility for the well-being of whānau and hapū by continuing our focus on, that rangatiratanga self-determination, which has anchored Ngai Tahu for generations. Our iwi has a long history of leadership in the whānau wellbeing space and has been actively working to address social and economic inequities for whānau since Te Tiriti settlement more than 20 years ago now. Te Pū Tahitanga o Te Waipounamu will continue in its role as the Whānau Order Commissioning Agency for the South Island, and I can also assure whānau that our exit from Te Pū Tahitanga will not impact on their access to services that is supported by Te Pū Tahitanga. We'll continue to stand alongside whānau with our capable health and social service providers. This is a step in establishing a true and authentic Te Tiriti partnership with the Crown. Many of those to come, as whānau are seeing, with the health reforms, with the stand-up of the Iwi Māori Partnership Board, with our relationship with Oranga Tamariki. So it's a change in the current environment that we're in.
Kia ora, Lisa. Thank you for that. Recently, you also shared with whānau the Pūtea Manaaki COVID-19 Relief Support Grant is open for applications. It's been a tough couple of years for whānau. Who should apply for this grant?
Yeah, Te Pūtea Manaaki COVID-19 Relief Support Grant, that's now open to all Ngai Tahu registered whānau living in Aotearoa over 18 years old. We've received over 1,000 applications from whānau so far. So if you or your whānau have been impacted by COVID-19 and you've had to isolate, you can apply for the grant. You could get up to $500, and I hope that that grant helps to ease some of the pressures whānau are experiencing with, for example, the cost of living is high, and as winter's upon us, it's a difficult time for whānau.
Definitely, it is getting colder. E te whānau, for more information on the Pūtea Manaaki grant and the application form, just head on to the website Te Runanga o Ngai Tahu. All the information is there. So next Friday, for the first time, Matariki will officially be recognised as a public holiday. So do you have any plan? What's your thoughts on that? It's the first Māori public holiday.
I'm looking forward to celebrating Matariki with my whānau, and I've got the special treat of my mokopuna. They're going to take the train across to the west coast, so we'll go down and pick them up on Friday, and so really looking forward to having whānau time and celebrating Matariki at home on the coast. Although each hapū celebrating differently, we may recognise puaka instead of Matariki. The important thing is that we're looking up at the sky, as our tupuna did before us. So I hope that you take this time, Te Whānau, to reflect on the year that's passed, on the loved ones that we've lost, celebrate with your loved ones that are still with us and, you know, plan for the future. I'd like to mihi to Te Rūnanga o Moeraki Chair and Representative Justin Tipper and Māori astronomer Victoria Campbell for sharing their whakaaro on Matariki, which featured last weekend on TVNZ Sunday show. You know, this was a groundbreaking story told only in Te Reo Māori during a primetime current affairs show. So a link's available, whānau, on the Naitahu Facebook page if you want to see it.
Kia ora, Lisa. Thank you so much for our kōrero this morning. Have you got lots planned for the rest of the day?
I'm in Te Rūnanga board meetings now from today until Friday, 5 p.m. So it's kind of like just closing off to everything else around us and focusing on our duties as representatives for our people.
Kia ora. Thank you for your kōrero. Have an awesome Matariki holiday and we'll catch up soon. Have a great rest of the day, Lisa.
Kia ora, Jay. Kia ora, whānau.